In this part, we will give the development of most powerful taste, giving its proof like existence part and its sufficient part. First, we shall give the definition of most powerful taste, and that taste is of size alpha. For this, we consider P as a family of probability measures indexed by a parameter theta belonging to script theta, which is a subset of script r to the power d. D belongs to the set of positive integers 1, 2, 3 up to infinity. That means script P is equal to plus of those P theta. Satisfying P theta is a probability measure on omega script A, and theta belongs to script theta. Now consider the problem of testing the hypothesis like H naught theta belonging to theta naught against H 1 that theta belongs to theta 1, where theta naught union theta 1 is a subspace of whole space, and theta naught intersection theta 1 is equal to null space. Let M alpha be the class of all level alpha tests for H naught and against H 1, and alpha belongs to the closed interval 0 1. And by the size or level of a test, we mean its expected value is less than is equal to alpha for all theta belonging to theta naught. What is the quantity that we have taken expectation? That is nothing but the function phi x, which we call the test function or critical function. Next, we consider x vector is equal to x1, x2, xn, where x1, x2, xn cut this part. Let x is equal to x1, x2, xn be n tuple iid random variables. That means it is a random sample from a certain distribution px theta, theta belongs to theta, and px theta is generated from capital P theta, which belongs to script P. Actually, px theta is probability density function or probability mass function of the set of random observations x, and px theta sometimes is the distribution function of a discrete random variable or some continuous random variable. So in any case, px theta is nothing but probability density function or probability mass function. Now, we want to give the definition of most powerful test. Actually, a level alpha test phi naught belonging to M alpha, that M alpha is script M alpha, is said to be most powerful, which is abbreviated as capital MP, for testing H naught that theta belongs to theta naught against the alternative theta is equal to theta 1 not belonging to theta naught if E theta 1 phi naught x is greater than is equal to E theta 1 phi x for all phi belonging to M alpha. Actually, most powerful means it has maximum power against a particular alternative theta is equal to theta 1 among all tests that are of level alpha. That means phi belonging to script M alpha. We state a theorem that is called Neyman-Pearson lemma, and this is of course the called fundamental part of the lemma. For testing theta is equal to theta naught, here theta naught is just a singleton set. Theta naught is a value of theta at a particular point. Against H1, theta is equal to theta 1, that is also a singleton point, and that theta 1 differs from theta naught. A test phi naught given by phi naught x is equal to 0 if px theta 1 is less than k into px theta naught and 1 if px theta 1 greater than k into px theta naught, where k is non-negative and phi naught on the boundary that x for all x px theta is equal to k px theta naught are so determined that e theta naught phi naught x is equal to alpha. Here alpha belongs to the open interval 0 1 and alpha is prefixed. Furthermore, if a test satisfies 1 and 2 and I put equation number 1 corresponding to phi naught x and equation number 2 corresponding to e theta naught phi naught x is equal to alpha. So, k and the boundary value are so determined that the test is of size alpha. Again, if phi naught is most powerful at level alpha for h naught against h 1, then for some k greater than is equal to 0, it satisfies 1 almost everywhere. It also satisfies 2 unless there exists a test for some for size less than alpha with power 1. First, we give the proof of the theorem in terms of its existence part, and then give its sufficient part, and the other part will contain the necessary part. For the existence part, we first define a random variable y which is equal to px theta 1 divided by px theta naught. Actually, px theta naught may be is equal to 0 for some values of x. So, we get p theta naught px theta naught greater than 0, that has probability measure under theta naught is equal to 1. So, the part px theta naught is equal to 0 can be neglected under the under theta is equal to theta naught in terms of probability. We take the random variable y to be non-negative with probability 1. Thus, the random variable y is well defined under the null hypothesis H naught. And to get the existence part, we define the probability measure like alpha y is equal to probability under theta naught of px theta naught. Let us define a function alpha y which is equal to p theta naught such that px theta 1 greater than y multiplied by px theta naught, and that can be written as px theta 1 greater than y into px theta 1 and px theta naught greater than 0. And that gives probability under theta naught of y greater than small y, and that gives 1 minus g theta naught y, where g theta naught y is the cumulative distribution function of y under the null hypothesis h naught. Let us define a function alpha y which is equal to p theta naught such that px theta 1 greater than y multiplied by px theta naught. And that can be written as px theta 1 greater than y into px theta 1 and px theta naught greater than 0. And that gives probability under theta naught of y greater than small y, and that gives 1 minus g theta naught y, where g theta naught y is the cumulative distribution function of y under the null hypothesis H naught. So, we have two situations. One situation is that k is continuity point for which we have alpha k is equal to alpha k minus 0, and that gives is equal to alpha. Then the test given by 1 satisfies 2 regardless of the choice of phi naught at the boundary. Sometimes k becomes the point of discontinuity, then we set phi naught at the boundary as gamma is equal to alpha minus alpha k divided by alpha k minus 0 minus alpha k. Thus, we get e theta naught phi naught x is equal to probability under theta naught px theta 1 greater than k multiplied by px theta naught plus gamma times p theta naught probability that x theta 1 is equal to k multiplied by px theta naught, and that gives alpha k plus alpha minus alpha k divided by alpha k minus 0 minus alpha k into alpha k minus 0 minus alpha k, and that becomes alpha. The existence part of a test of the form 1 satisfying 2 has now been established. Next, I come to the proof of the sufficient part. For the sufficient part, we shall prove that any test of the form 1 satisfying 2 is most powerful. We pick any phi belonging to script m alpha. Then, for any x belonging to script x, actually that script x is the sample space. Consider the product phi naught x minus phi x multiplied by p x theta 1 minus k into p x theta naught by 1. When p x theta 1 is greater than k into p x theta naught, we get phi naught x is equal to 1, and that is greater than is equal to any phi x belonging to 0 1. Similarly, when p x theta 1 is less than k into p x theta naught, we get phi naught x is equal to 0, which is less than is equal to any phi x belonging to 0 1. Automatically, the difference phi naught x minus phi x into p x theta 1 minus k p x theta naught is greater than is equal to 0. Of course, when p x theta 1 is equal to k p x theta naught, we get the product is equal to 0. Now, phi naught x minus phi x into p x theta 1 minus k into p x theta naught greater than is equal to 0, and that implies integration over phi naught x minus phi x multiplied by p x theta 1 minus k p x theta naught into dx is greater than is equal to 0. Naturally, if we multiply phi naught x by p x theta 1, we get e theta 1 phi naught x, and if we multiply phi x by p x theta naught, we get e theta 1 phi x of and phi x p x theta 1 multiplied by p x theta 1 dx, we get e theta 1 phi x. Phi naught x multiplied by p x theta naught integration over script x, we will get e theta naught phi naught x, and phi x multiplied by p x theta naught integrated over script x, we will get e theta naught phi x. And naturally, we get e theta 1 phi naught x minus e theta 1 phi x is greater than is equal to k multiplied by e theta naught phi naught x minus e theta naught phi x. And we have e theta naught phi naught x is equal to alpha, and e theta naught phi x is less than is equal to alpha for all phi belonging to m alpha. Ultimately, we get that product is greater than is equal to 0. Hence, we get e theta 1 phi naught x is greater than is equal to e theta 1 phi x for all phi belonging to m alpha. This proves the sufficient part of the theorem, that means phi naught is most powerful of its size. From this theorem, we can say that if there are n independent observations from normal distribution with common mean mu and variance unity, we can find most powerful test for testing mu is equal to mu naught against mu greater than mu 1 by using the ratio p x theta 1 divided by p x theta naught, and that gives ultimately that the test based on the sample mean is uniformly based for testing mu is equal to mu naught against mu is equal to mu 1. Actually, that test is right tail test based on x bar, and that tail point can be determined by using the level alpha cutoff point of normal distribution with mean mu variance 1 by root n, 1 by n. That gives the idea of getting most powerful test by using Neumann-Pearson lemma and using the normal distribution. and it can be shown that this test is independent of any alternative mu 1 greater than mu 0. So, that test can also be said as uniformly most powerful for testing mu is equal to mu 0 against every mu such that mu greater than mu 0, and that test is of size alpha. In this part, we have given the idea of getting most powerful or uniformly most powerful test using those distributions which have range independent of the parameter under consideration. In the next part of the section, we will give some idea when the range of the distribution is depending on theta.